So welcome back to Cloudforest Vibes. Today I'm going to do a quick mounting video, or remounting video. I've got four new Lepanthes that I got from Equigenera about 3 weeks ago or so, and I'm dying to get them off the little cork tiles that they're on and onto something more natural looking. I like regular cork bark, virgin cork bark, and I'm going to show you how to go about doing that today. So first things first, I've got everything needed here to mount. I've got cork bark, I've got bits of wire, I've got some sphagnum moss that's been moistened a little bit. I've got some tweezers soaking in alcohol and some nice little aquascaping scissors. Have a little curved blade to them. I like to use those a lot too. They're really helpful. Also soaking in alcohol. And a straight razor blade, just in case. I like to use that obviously to cut anything off tie-wise, and then sometimes it helps to, you know, extract bits of the roots off of degrading mounts and things like that. I've got a drill with a small drill bit and some fishing line, and then let's see, a pair of straight cutting pliers and a pair of regular pliers. You don't need both, I just have them, so I use them. And that's it. So we'll get started by showing you how to make the mount. I take a piece of cork appropriately sized for the plant, my drill, get started, make a hole. Take your wire, I feed it through from the back, over the top, and cross the wire just like that. Take the pliers and you just do one twist. Full twist. So, cut off my little nub. And there you have a brand new mount. So, from this point, what I like to do, I have a spray bottle here with some alcohol. I always give it a good spray. These have already been sterilized, but I'm always careful with them. And then I'm going to take that and rinse that off under the tap, and I'll be right back and show you the next step. Okay, so we're back again. I've got four mounts made for four plants in just a few moments, really. It doesn't take a whole long time. Once you do it a couple times, it becomes really easy. And what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and we're going to clean up the plants. We're going to get them off their mounts and show you that even though it might be scary as hell the first couple times, doing miniatures really isn't any different than doing a normal sized orchid. So, take the tag off. This is where the razor blade comes in. I always like to cut that off. You can, I don't know if you can see that or not, but this cork tile right here is very spongy. I mean, that just sinks right into it. So that's where that may come in handy again. Go ahead and give it a dip in the alcohol. That is 70% isopropyl. Go ahead and get our tweezers ready. We're probably going to need them. And I like to first get whatever they bound it off with, bound it on there off. Yeah. So we'll pull that. Sure, we're not messing the roots up as we do it. There's some really nice moss on here. I may save just a little bit of it. I have a thing for moss, so it'll get propagated and put back onto other mounts. That's really neat. Lots of good moss. So, here we have our orchid. unbound, or however you like to call it. I got a bowl here, I just put trash in. This thing's easier for cleanup. And we're gonna start gently teasing away the sphagnum moss that is down on the bottom of the mount, where the roots should be. This is where the tweezers comes in handy, if you don't drop them. So if you kind of get them in there, hopefully you can see that. Gently lift. See how attached the plant even is. So oftentimes, if they're kept really moist, something I did forget to do, I like to give them a good spray. Kind of softens things up a bit. But oftentimes you'll find, especially when they're on these cork tiles, that they don't really attach that well. So, just poke around, find out what parts of the plant are attached and what aren't. And then you can start teasing away this moss and exposing what roots are there. So this moss is really compacted. It stinks. You can smell it in the whole little miniature orchidarium that I have. Stinks. It smells like these couple mounts, but especially this one. So I started with this one. So it does have some nice roots on it. They are teasing away, but expose them a bit more. See where they're clinging on. There's one. I did break one. You're gonna break them. Don't be scared. As long as you don't tear them all off, they will grow back just like any other orchid. And there, completely off. So this is gonna go here. I'll take the wire off. We'll probably use the wire again. I'm stingy. All this moss goes straight into the garbage. Let's see. Now, for small orchids like this, I think it's important the way that you hold them. Let me get over here where you can see me. So, I like to kind of gently place them in my hand, and I kind of just gently hold the base just a little bit. And that way you can kind of tease, figure out where the moss goes, because these little tiny roots are in there. This has decent roots, so we'd like to try to preserve them just like you would with any other plant. Again, you're gonna break a couple. It's not the end of the world. Now, if it only has a couple and you break them, that might be a different story, but generally speaking, these grow really vigorously. If you get them in the right conditions, so you're not going to have to worry, and they don't have a rest period or anything like that. They're constantly growing, constantly blooming. They want to grow. So we're getting down to the nitty gritty here, and this is really where the tweezers come in handy. So again, holding the base of the plant very gently, I use the tweezers and I just kind of comb through the roots a little bit. Sometimes I'll clamp them together so I'm not tempted to squeeze. And you just kind of comb out any bad moss you have. Pick it out a little bit. If this starts taking too long, I'll probably skip through it, but that's really it. I do also give them a spray with hydrogen peroxide. I know I've already wetted the plant with water, so I'm definitely not scared of this having any adverse effects. I've used it quite a bit with Lepanthes. They don't seem to mind too bad. Make sure there's no critters or funguses that I'm going to transfer over to the new mount. So I will probably skip forward a little bit, and we'll come back when I have the rest of this little moss off of here. This is the tedious part. So we're back now. I've got this thing as cleaned up as I'm gonna go. It's as far as I wanna take it. There's still some live moss in there. I'm gonna leave it. It's just gonna go ahead and transfer onto its new mount, which I'm perfectly okay with live moss transferring onto things. But this is the root system. Hopefully you can see that pretty well. I don't know if you can or not. They're small, they're wiry. Think bulbophyllum or something like that. But I've also got a bunch of stems here from leaves that have dropped. So we're gonna go ahead and separate those off. You can give them a tug, see if they come off, but if they don't, usually they will, then I like to just kind of cut them. The base of the plant can be a bit sensitive. It will come apart, so you do want to be careful. It's actually a leaf. We don't want to cut that. That's why I like the curved scissors. You can kind of get in there. You have a little bit better control and make real fine cuts when you're dealing with some of these miniatures. It really helps. These were like less than $10 on Amazon. If I think about it, I will put a link in the description where you can find them. And again, this isn't necessary. It just cleans up the appearance of the plant a bit. And I like to have a nice clean plant, a nice fresh start when I'm putting a plant on a new mount. That's it, just a few little stems. All right, give it one more little shot with some water. Clean it up. These are Cloudforest orchids. You do not have to worry about getting them wet unless they stay wet for too long. That's it. Probably can't tell much of a difference, but that's our cleaned up Lepanthes. This is Sherry Brideham. And it's getting ready to go on a new mount. Now, I did not select mounts for each plant. I just kind of picked four that are a good size. So I think, let's look at them. This one's one of the smallest of the four, so we're going to go with the smallest of the four mounts. Nice and holy and rugged, lots of places for roots to climb into, lots of places to hold some moisture. Perfect mount for Lepanthes. Go ahead and put our tools back in our alcohol, keep them nice and sterile in case we have to use them again. And then attach the plant to the mount. That's gonna look nice. So we're gonna take our plant. I like to take on a mount that has holes like this. I just take little pieces of moss, and I'll kind of stick them in the hole a bit. Untie it here. That way, if the root gets down in there, it's got a nice moist place to go already, and there's no big air gaps. Just take a piece, it's kind of big. Just kind of put it on there. Through the holes. Now, all I've done, I'll show you guys, is stuffed a little bit of moss in a couple of those holes. I'm still going to mount this orchid to that bare piece of cork right there. That way its roots can go anywhere they want. And they're going to end up in a little bit of moss, and I'm going to use just a tiny bit of moss on top of the roots so they still get a lot of air to them. Secret to them, just like any other orchids, They need to have air to the roots. I don't care how small they are, what a cloud forest environment they come from. Most orchids do not ever want their roots to be soggy and need to have air to them, especially if they're epiphytic. So we have our plant, one turn, secured, just over the roots. The roots kind of spread out a bit on that bare piece of bark. And we're going to put our bottle back on the line to kind of keep our line where we want it. We're going to take, it's still quite a bit of moss, just trim you up. So I've got just one piece of moss. It's got three little legs to it. And I am literally just going to lay it over the roots, one layer, and that's all it's going to need. That is all this plant is ever going to need. Do not want to smother it. So, one wrap, two wraps, three wraps. Still got several more if I need it. I took too much line. And I think that's going to do it. I mean, that's all you really want. The base of your plant is still exposed. The roots are gently covered with moss, just one little layer. And that is that. So we're going to go ahead and cut off all this excess line. This thing tied off. Now, just like a lot of people, you hear people talk about making the V, you just stick your tag end right through that V, so you have something to pull against, and you just tie it off. You just take the same end, one, and you go through the loop with the same ends twice. Okay. Pull it tight. I like to cut off the excess. And there you have beautifully mounted Lepanthes. Simple. So I'm not going to bore you with the other ones. I'm just going to go ahead and do them. And we'll come back when I have all four done, and we'll go find the place for them in the orchidarium. Okay, so I kind of lost my good filming light, but I did finish all four mounts, so I kind of went to circle back around and show you guys what happened. So here's our four Lepanthes off the cork, off the cork tile, onto beautiful pieces of cork of their own. They just look so much nicer on a natural looking mount. And they came through it really, really well. So I kind of wanted to show you a little bit of what I do when I first get them. Here's my watering station here. Excuse the mess. Gets used quite a bit. But I've already sprayed them down with regular water. And what we're going to do now is we're going to take some CalMag dosed at about 60 parts per million. And I just like to water them real good with CalMag. Oop, trailed off there, sorry. Get them really good with CalMag. And I'm also going to give them a little bit of kelp max, also at about 40 to 60 parts per million. This we're just going to give them a little trickle. We don't need too much of this. I find that it helps them bounce back a little bit quicker and keeps a happier orchid. So I do not like to feed them for at least a week or maybe 2 weeks. I like to just in case there's any root damage, let the roots kind of heal a bit and let the plant kind of settle before I start feeding it. But I will give it Kelp Max and CalMag with just about every watering for the next week or so until I start feeding. I'll give it a real good flush as well once a week just to make sure they're happy and acclimating to their new mounts really well. So that's it. That's how you remount Lepanthes. I'll put some before and after pics on. I'll let you guys be the judge, but I think they look a whole lot better like this. They're just so stunning. Anyways, thanks for joining. Thanks for tuning in again. I greatly appreciate all you, and I hope you have a wonderful time out there. I hope you're staying safe. Yeah, happy growing.